Hey guys, welcome to the video. In this video, I'm going to do something a little bit different. I am going to be sharing some of the comments that I got on my most recent 7 Secrets of Moms Who Always Have Clean Homes video. Several of you guys left comments saying what you do to keep your house always clean, and I am going to share some of those and then I'm going to judge them. I'm just kidding. But I'm going to share whether I do them or not and whether I think it would be a good idea for new moms or for moms with older kids or things like that, and just talk through some of the ideas. I absolutely love it when you guys leave these comments on the videos, adding to the conversation and adding to some of the things that I have shared. So I will be popping in the comments so you guys can see who said it, give credit where credit is due. And yeah, we're basically just gonna go into some of the ideas that you guys have. And even if I don't personally do one of these ideas, it doesn't mean that it doesn't work or that it wouldn't be a great addition for someone else's cleaning routine. So I'm just gonna be sharing these with you and sharing my thoughts about each of these ideas. Before we get into this video, just a reminder that my membership, Total Home Transformation, is currently open for enrollment. And something special just for my viewers, if you use code YouTube at checkout, you will get $5 off your first month's membership, and you'll also get $5 off every month you are a member. You get detailed lessons and help with every single step of the way. So if streamlining is a goal of yours, I hope to see you inside the membership. All right, let's get into this video. So like I said, there was such a good response to the last video and I got so many awesome ideas from you guys, but I just took the top 7 ideas for things that people said I should add to future lists and things that they do in their homes. And I am going to read those for you guys and tell you what I think of the ideas. Now, one of the commenters said something that I think is absolutely key, and I just want to reiterate that for you guys now. The goal is not always clean, even though I have put that in the title of the videos. The goal is easy to clean. The reason it's in the title is YouTube likes it when you say kind of extreme things in the titles and it makes people click on the videos more. I don't fully understand it. So I just want to mention that to make sure everyone's expectations are realistic and this isn't putting needless pressure on moms. The goal is to have houses that are easy to clean, easy to put back in order. And of course, when you have kids and your home and your life, things are going to get messy from time to time. And that's honestly part of the fun. Another really good point that one of the commenters made is tidiness should be for yourself and your family, not to impress guests. I do talk about this in some of my other videos, like the recent one I did on creating a weekly cleaning routine. Make sure when you're creating your cleaning routines is to make yourself and your family comfortable, and it's not based on anyone else's expectations of your home. Yes, you do want when people come over to feel welcomed and to feel like your home is tidy, but you shouldn't feel like you have to clean the house from top to bottom to please anyone else. So I think that was an excellent point, and I just wanted to put that out there, make sure you guys hear and see that comment as well, because I think that is really important for moms to hear. So the first comment that I want to bring up, and I'm going to read it to make sure that I get it right, it says, only have expectations for others, i.e. your family members, that you have for yourself first. And I would call this one leading by example. And I think this is just such a good point to bring up. Sometimes it seems obvious, but we can sometimes put expectations on other people, like our kids, that we aren't necessarily upholding ourselves. And that can really make our kids not respect us as parents and can lead to a lot of frustration within that parent-child dynamic. So if you're going to expect your kids to keep their rooms clean, make sure you are keeping your room clean as well. So I think this is a fantastic point. And yes, absolutely the secret of moms who always have clean houses. They make sure to lead by example and make sure the rules are kind of fair for everyone. This next secret is actually from the same commenter, and I think this is another excellent point. It says, require children to clean up after themselves if they are 5 or older. A mother is not a house slave. And I love that so much. I absolutely think that this is an important secret to keeping your home clean all the time. Oh, I was going to say whether I use these tips or not. So, or these secrets, whatever we want to call them. So the first one, yes, I do strive to do that. I strive to have expectations for myself and my kids that are similar. I will be honest though, this is actually something that I have been trying to work on more because I do try to keep the entire house really clean and I expect my children to keep their rooms clean. However, sometimes my room does get a little messy, and I had actually been thinking about that well, this last week, I think I said I had been pretty sick. My room got really crazy. I didn't exactly clean it in a timely manner, and I do need to get better at that. I need to make sure I'm keeping my room to the same standard that my kids' room is being held to. So I appreciate this comment because it kind of reminded me I need to work on this one, but I do think it is very, very important, and I think it's an important one to implement in your home. So the second one, requiring children to clean up after themselves if they are 5 and up, I absolutely agree with this, and I do implement this in our house, but I would say you can even do it younger than 5. Like with my 2-year-old, I can't tell him always clean up after yourself and expect him to do it, but after he is done playing with something, I can sit with him and say, okay, you need to put the magnet tiles away. And I'll usually repeat it multiple times at, you know, if he gets distracted or doing something else, I'll say, clean up, put the magnet tiles away. So I think you can start teaching it younger, but you know, maybe around that 5 age, like she said, you can have that as an expectation in the house for sure. So yes, like that one, use that one. I think that's a really good tip. The next tip or secret or hack, I should have figured out what I was going to call this before I started this video, but comes from the same viewer. She had a whole list of really good ones that I wanted to point out. This next one is wash the laundry less. She said, I have a friend who can't keep up with the laundry, who washes her towels after every use. So I love this idea. I actually talk about it in my laundry tips video. I go through all of my tips and secrets for getting laundry done. But washing clean laundry is a trap that a lot of moms fall into. And this was an interesting one for me because I actually grew up in a house where my mom had been raised to wash her towels after every use. And I will definitely say it made the laundry really difficult to keep up with because there was so much of it. I mean, we had 5 people in our family. You're washing then a full load of towels every day in addition to all the clothes. And it makes it very much so that the laundry is overwhelming, it's really hard to keep up with, and it tends to then not be kept up with. So once I had my own home, I decided to try just doing the towels once a week. It just made sense in my brain. You're clean when you use the towel. It's probably okay for a little bit, and it is much more manageable and much easier to get that done. And then I actually do my towels on a day when I don't do regular laundry. So when I'm looking at my weekly cleaning schedule and my weekly routine, we do that on our busiest day because folding the towels is actually pretty easy. So that's a nice easy fold for our busy day when we're running around. I also talk about in that laundry video that often, especially with kids, they will just, they change clothes a lot, at least mine do. Sometimes they will wear one outfit for the morning and one outfit for the afternoon, and then there's another outfit for bedtime. And every time they change, their inclination is to put it into the laundry. And I always ask my kids, is that actually dirty? Or could it be worn again? And sometimes it is, you know, sometimes they were out playing in the mud or whatever, but sometimes if they wore it for 2 hours and then they realized, oh, it's a little hotter than I thought, I'm gonna change into shorts, you don't actually need to wash those jeans. And sometimes jeans can be worn 2, 3, 4 times before they need wash. I don't know if that grosses some people out, but you don't actually have to wash every single thing, every single use. I mean, for hundreds, thousands of years, people washed all their laundry once a week and they wore the same dresses and clothes all throughout the week. So I definitely agree we overwash laundry, and this is something that can really help keep your house clean and keep the laundry from becoming an overwhelming problem. So I think it's safe to say, yes, this is something that I implement in my house and highly recommend this tip for anyone who is overwashing their laundry. So thank you so much, Julianne, for that comment, and you actually had some other really great ideas as well. So maybe, I don't know if I can pin multiple comments, but maybe I will kind of take turns pinning some of these comments that were really helpful to make sure everyone can see them. But we're going to move on to another comment now, and she also had a couple of good ideas. So the first one was to do the essentials consistently and kind of let the other stuff go, and then when you do a deep clean, you can do that. And she mentions how her essentials are toilets, floors, table, kitchen, laundry, and all the important stuff like that she does regularly. And then she says, my deep cleaning routine looks more like, oh, there's a spider web, let me get that. And I love that because she has actually streamlined her home already, so she doesn't have to spend a lot of time on things that aren't essentials either. So yes, I think this is a great tip, and it is one that we implement in our home. And I recommend this for any moms who want to make their cleaning a little bit easier. Now, the next one that I have from this commenter, she says, I have decluttered my home and I have to continue to monitor my inventory to keep things manageable for me. And I think this is so important. Yes, you won't ever have to go back through and completely declutter your home again as long as you set boundaries and make sure that you actually completely decluttered it the first time. But there are certain areas like kids' toys, you know, birthdays and Christmases happen and all of a sudden you have twice as many toys as you did before. And another area you need to monitor is like under the sink, medicine cabinets, offices, things like that. So I have never had to go back through and completely declutter my home top to bottom, but about once a year I will take inventory in some areas and make sure that things are still kind of as decluttered as I would like them to be and manageable. I like the way she said that. I want to make sure that it's manageable for myself. So yes, love this comment. I think this is a fantastic tip and definitely one that I implement in my home as well. Okay, now we're moving on to a different comment again, and I'm going to read what they have to say. It says, another easy habit is wiping down the shower walls every few days while you're already in there. Now, this is not personally something that I do in my home, but this comment got a lot of likes on it, so I'm thinking that there are others that may do this as well. And I would love to know in the comments, let me know, you guys, do you think that I should try this out and see if I think it's something that should be implemented and something that works for me? Or if you guys just want to tell me also, if you do this, how do you do it? Do you guys use any sprays or anything like that to wipe it down? Or do you just use a washcloth and the water and soap that's already in there? How do you guys do this step? I've heard this before, so I'm thinking there are a lot of people that do it, but it's just not something that I have ever implemented. So let me know if you guys think I should try it. I think maybe for myself, I would need to do it every time I shower just to build a habit. I don't know that I would remember to do it like every third time or something like that. So let me know how you guys do it and let me know if you think I should try this one out. I do think it's a good idea, especially if you have the time to do it. Now, if you are a mom with a brand new baby and you already have a lot going on, I probably wouldn't recommend you do this. But if your kids are older and able to help with some of the other chores, I think A, this is something you could definitely do for yourself, and B, it's something you could teach them to do. So yeah, let me know what you guys think if you do this and if you like it. And then the seventh and last tip that I have for this video also comes from this same commenter, and it says, we wipe down the toilets daily and it only takes a second. They get a good scrub on the weekend. So that is another one that I have not implemented in my house. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys think I should give it a try. I have heard of a lot of people doing this, wiping down the toilets daily. To me, I feel like that will take more time than I want it to in cleaning my toilets, but I haven't tried it. So if you guys think that I need to try the wiping down the showers and wiping down the toilets, I will do that and I can report back to you how it goes. But I would also love to hear in the comments from those of you that do this, do you feel like it's worth it? Do you feel like it really doesn't take any time at all? And it's just an easy thing to do to keep things kind of sparkling. Again, if you are a new mom with a little baby, or even if you have lots of kids that are young, I would say on these last two, don't stress yourself out about doing these at this point. When your kids get a little bit older though, I think that this could be a really great thing to do, especially if you're someone that really needs the house to be clean, really needs the bathrooms to be clean. I know some people just really like them to be perfectly clean all the time. For me personally, I feel like once a week is enough, but everyone has a different standard of clean, right? Everyone has a different standard of what feels good to them with that and what they would like to do. So I'd love to hear from those of you in the comments down below that do these things. Let me know what your thoughts are, how often you do it, how long it takes. And again, follow-up question on this one, when you wipe it down, are you using a spray? Do you keep sprays in the bathroom with this? Or is it something where you will just like grab a washcloth or some toilet paper and just wipe it down? I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know if you would like me to try it and report back how I like it. That's all I had for this video. If you would like to streamline your home in record time so that you can add 7 extra hours to your week, consider joining my membership, Total Home Transformation, and don't forget to use the coupon code YouTube at checkout for $5 off every month. As always, I'm Cassie with streamlineyourhome.com. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the notification bell so you'll be notified when the next video comes out.